have group chat.
Da 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 da. Medulla of the meniscus in a dilution. In a Kim building not too far away from here. Four guys. Kim guy one. Kim guy two. Kim guy three. And Kim guy four, Mr. Taco Cat. Are going to embark to form the Kill Kids of Chemistry. Wait, no, that just sounds wrong. To do a project that's been done over and over and over and over. And they're going to do it again. So slap on a pair of safety goggles. And make sure your pants cover your ankles and your shoes are closed too. Because these chemicals aren't here to play. And let's get started. So, what the heck are dilutions? Well, if you Google dilutions, the vast wisdom of the internet will tell you that a dilution is the action of making a liquid more dilute, which is about as helpful as knowing that a stick comes from a tree, which is not very useful. So let's put it in layman's term. Because scientists are sesquipid aliens, they created the fancy word dilutions for watering down stuff, quote unquote. In this epic lab here, we watered down, or diluted, the clear sugar water with the blue pure water. To give an analogy, let's look at leche. Take chocolate leche, for example. Chocolate leche, when mixed with about equal amounts of white leche, creates a mixture that is not quite as chocolatey as the first leche, but a little bit more chocolatey than the other leche, the white leche. This principle can be applied, in general, to most dilutions. So easy, in fact, that you can do it. Yes, you! Look at that equation. M1V1 is equal to M2V2. It's really that simple, guys. V, of course, stands for volume, how much space it takes up. A little bit, or a lot. 1 liter, or 2 liters. And we don't use cups, or pints, or gallons, or whatever imperial unit blasphemy that they can come up with over in Liberia. Imperial unit scum. Okay, on to M. M stands for molarity, which is like the concentration of a substance. Again, it has a little bit of chocolate, or a lot of chocolate. A lot of sugar, or a little bit of sugar. Mama always said, don't knock it till you try it, so let's try a problem together. Okay, we have two flasks. One has sugar water of about 20%, the other has pure water, which is the one that's kind of pure. In our case, it'd be blue water in our actual experiment. Now, if we're putting them in various ratios together, we'll create different types of concentrations. For example, if we put a lot of 20% and almost no pure water in the flask, it'll get us 20% sugar water. If we put a lot of pure water and no sugar water, that means it'll get us like 0% or maybe 1% sugar water. If we mixed them equally, it'd be about 10% sugar water. If we did a lot of sugar water but a little bit of pure water, it'd be like 15.8%. So let's say we have a 10 milliliter volumetric flask. And so that'll be our V2. And we want 5% sugar water, but we only have 20% sugar water, which would be our M1. Where M2 is what we want it to be, our 5%. So we're going to rearrange equation to find our V1. And you may be wondering, what does V1 stand for? Well, when we solve for V1, that tells us how much sugar water to put in there, which we calculated to be 2.5 here, which means that we put 2.5 milliliters of the 20% sugar water into the little 10 milliliter volumetric flask. And then we put the pure water to fill it up to the line until the meniscus hits mark. What is a meniscus? What a great segue. A meniscus is a mushy in the tushy. A curve that results from the cohesion and adhesion forces in fluids. It's like a dimple in the water. Now note that chem student 1 fills it up until the base of the dimple hits the mark. Chem student 2 then verifies, and then lastly chem student 3 writes it down. Because that's what separates science from screwing around people. Writing it down. Like a boss. Now let's take a closer look as chem student 2 comes in to fit that. See it, don't ya? Always wear your safety goggles, people, even if it's just water. Just do it. Okay, now note that he uses a transfer beaker, not the stock, to get fluid to put into the volumetric flask. And then he raises it with a graduated pipette until the meniscus hits the mark of the volumetric flask. This is important. Note that he also, again using a transfer pipette and a transfer beaker, he also checks the meniscus in the transfer pipette before putting it into the volumetric flask. Important. Finally, we're scientists, not casuals. Always clean up your mess. Don't leave it for the rest.
Science, 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 science!